Learning how to filter properly in a Power BI environment as a consumer is one of the best possible things you can do. If you know how to filter properly, you can easily access the information you are wanting for insights in under 10 seconds. So before we go into mastering the filtering system, it would be important to know how Microsoft describes filters. They describe it as sorting data and information based on some selected criteria. So when you, the user or the consumer, select a criteria within a filter, you are referencing the whole database underneath this dashboard to only look at that criteria. Now there's two different sets of filters that you could utilize. For developers, they can either put it on the dashboard itself or they can put it in the filter pane. Both of them serves the same purpose. Now we filter to only Office 365 as a product category here. And you can tell that all the KPIs in the tables and the graphs and the visuals, they're all matching to spit out data specific to Office 365, which was our selected criteria in the filter. So let's go ahead and remove Office 365 as our selected criteria in our product category here. We can do that by going to the eraser icon, pressing that, and then that'll remove the criteria completely from the dashboard. So let's go ahead and move over to the product filter. But this time, let's see if we can filter multiple criteria or multiple products in this case to spit out the data that we're looking for. So while holding down control on your keyboard, if you scroll down on your mouse and click on any one of these products, that will select the multiple criteria that you're looking for. So we're gonna grab Excel, we're gonna grab Power BI, and let's grab Power Apps. Let's go ahead and close this filter, and boom. You're seeing Power BI, Excel, and Power Apps data only for the dashboard. So let's go ahead and remove the selection criteria we did for the product. And we'll go back up to the dashboard level filter, go to the eraser, we'll remove that. Now let's head over to the filter pane. The filter pane can also accomplish the exact same task of filtering by criteria that the dashboard level filters can. It's with the filter pane that the consumer or the user will have more advanced capabilities and functionality compared to the dashboard level filters. So let's go ahead and try it. We're gonna open up the product category field in the filter pane. We're gonna select Office 365 as our criteria, and it is as simple as just clicking on the little checkbox. So once we do that, we're getting all data related to Office 365. And this is the exact same KPIs and look that we had with the dashboard level filter. So let's go ahead and verify this with the product level field. So we're gonna remove the product category by going to the eraser icon. We're gonna open up the product field. We're gonna multiple select by Excel, Power BI, and Power Apps like we had before. And it's important to note that when you're selecting multiple criteria within the filter pane, you do not have to hold down the control button on your keyboard. Is as simple as just pressing the box within the filter. Now our data is matching exactly to what we had in our dashboard level filter. That means our slicing and dicing of data is working perfectly fine. So another thing I want to point out is that you will see a number next to a criteria when you open up a field. And this number equates to the number of rows that are being presented within a visual. So if we click on Office 365, the number 19 means the number of unique rows that are being presented. So in this table, there is 19 separate rows that show data. Now, unless you pause the video and actually counted every single row in the table, you just assume that you trusted me that there was 19. So let's choose a different criteria for you to actually see how many rows there are. So let's pick Power Platform, that has 3. And as you can tell in the table here, there's 3 unique rows. So that is indeed working. In the next video, we're going to take this filtering system to another level. So it is important that you understand the core concepts of filtering before we move forward.